Even a year ago, if you got a brand new computer, the typical scenario of starting to browse the internet would be connecting to wired or wireless network and launching Microsoft's built-in Edge browser to download Google Chrome and finally surfing the net using it. But hold on, do you actually have to download Chrome from now on? Microsoft is working to improve its default Edge browser, and by testing its preview build, it seems that it's not bad at all. For the past couple of months, Microsoft worked to develop the Edge browser by utilizing the Chromium open source project. The Chromium open source project is like a program that other developers are free to use, and companies like Microsoft can use this program and build their very own browser. Many browsers like Opera, Brave, Amazon Silk, Avast Secure have been built using this open source project. So after a long period of developing, Microsoft released the preliminary version of the browser through three different channels: Beta channel, which is yet to be released, Dev channel, and the Canon channel, with the main difference between this being the update frequency and hence the stability. Without any further delay, let's get straight into the browser. As soon as it launches, we see a different Edge. It lets you customize the start page in four different styles, starting with the focused, which is quite basic, inspirational, which frames the Bing photo of the day, informational, which showcases newsfeed, and the remaining one is the custom layout. Browsing the web on this new browser feels more Chrome-like, with the new rounded corner tabs, profile icon to the right of the address bar, and particularly when you often click on the three-dot menu button, which looks more like that of Google Chrome. The only things that make you realize that you are using Edge and not Chrome is the start page, the new settings page, and when Bing pops up when you search. Okay, you can change it to other search engines later on. One of the major drawbacks of the Edge till date has been the limited number of and access to web extensions. It used to support extensions from its own web store only. However, the use of Chromium open source project means this time Edge will support extensions from the Chrome web store as well. Good news for the Chrome users, as they won't have any shortage of resources when they make the switch. Moreover, switching from any browser to Edge is much easier now with just one click from the settings. Talking about the settings, it's a whole different story now. Instead of the sidebar, it now features a dedicated settings tab where you can tailor the browser according to the needs. Also, there are some features, both old and new, that are not completely implemented in the browser for now. You can access those in the flex menu, like the smooth scrolling, dark mode, reading view, most importantly the Play Ready DRM, which lets you stream 4K contents. All these features are still in development and are expected to make their ways into the final software user interface. Microsoft has also promised to add a bunch of new features, like the Internet Explorer compatibility mode to render old web pages, collections for additional productivity like organizing, sharing, exporting, etc. with Microsoft Office products, new privacy controls which give users more control over their privacy by providing three levels of privacy gears. After using it for about a week now, I think that the Edge is a great browser for Microsoft, and this might be the browser we all have been waiting for. With many tabs opened, each loading more or less image-heavy websites, the experience is quite good. It is fast, almost as fast as Chrome, and it feels very snappy and responsive. Also, it is a bit less resource demanding, unlike the although it is not fair to compare these two at this point, as one is still being developed. According to the benchmark results, it does a pretty decent job, although it should be noted that the performance scores of the new Edge might change after the final software release. Head-to-head, the new Edge has it all to beat Chrome, although falling behind it by small margins in some of the benchmarks. And comparing it to the classic Edge indicates why Microsoft needed a huge boost in their default browser. Microsoft's approach to work on the Chromium open source project is not only going to benefit the users of Edge, but also those of the Chrome, as Microsoft looks forward to help Google enhance their Chrome browser in order to make it more efficient, less resource-hog, lightweight, and easygoing on the battery like the Edge for the laptop users out there. So that's all about it. Let me know what you guys think about the Microsoft Chromium Edge in the comments below, and I'll see you guys in the next one.